Hello guys, so in today's lecture we are going to talk about electron microscopy. So as name suggests, here the illuminating is not bulb, but here the illumination is done by using of electron. This is the second type of microscopy. First type microscopy is light microscopy and second type microscopy is electron microscopy. So there is some difference between light microscopy and electron microscopy, which I made a video on difference between light microscopy and electron microscopy. So here we see the parts of electron microscopy and the types of electron microscopy. So mainly the electron is generated by electron gun. A V-shaped electron gun is here. Now, V-shaped electron gun is made up of a tungsten filament. Because we are getting an electron to getting a metal. From metal we are getting an electron. So metal, the tungsten filament is withstand into 3000 Celsius. So we give a power about 4200 kilovolt. So at that power the tungsten filament it become excited and providing an electron beam. So it's simply providing electron, but the heat is very more. So to reduce the heat, to do not deflect or do not damage our system, we placing a one cap near the V shape of our filament. So this cap is called walnut cap. This has a bottom neck, a open bottom neck. So by this is cathode and this is also negative charge. So electron beam is deflected into downward, because the electron microscope is inverted. So our source of electron is a higher and our specimen is below the light source. So by this the electron is generated. Now behind this or down this, the anode is present. The anode has no power to give. Because it has no power, the emission is and the acceleration is occurred, because the electron beam has a power of 4200 kilovolt and the anode has no power. So by this the acceleration is occurred. This is called acceleration process. By this acceleration is occur. Now in walnut cap is made up of metal. Now the process of metal to heating and emission of electron, it is called a thermionic emission. So by thermionic emission we get an electron. Now the second thing is different is the electromagnetic lenses. The lenses that look like that. Yeah, the small opening. The lenses is made up of a firing. The wiring is higher into the lenses because the source of radiation is electron. So simple glass lens cannot be used. So we use a simple electromagnetic lens. This is the power given 1 ampere. Is power given to the 1 ampere power is given to the electromagnetic lens. Now electromagnetic lens is made up of. This look like that. I show you an image. Here the beads is present. So beam is straightened, not go anywhere. The work of this is completely to straight the beam, and resolution is getting higher by using this lens. Now third thing is difference is vacuum system. Now why we need vacuum? In air there is lots of molecules which collide with the electron. So by vacuum system we reduce the collision of electron. The vacuum is generated at two levels. Before the instrument starts, that's where the standard rotary motor pump is there. So what this do? the rotary prong is reduced the molecules inside the instrument. Now at second, the oil pump is there at second level. So this creates an electron gun. So this is the basic instrumentation or differentiation between electron microscopy and light microscopy by instrumentation. Now the electron microscopy has two types, TEM and SEM, transmission electron microscopy and scanning electron microscopy. As name suggests, transmission. So electron is transmit to the object. So here internal structure is observed by TEM, and here the scan, the object is scanned. Object is scanned. So only outer area or topological area, the shape is given by SEM. So molecules or shape are given by, like crystals are given by SEM. Now the standard method is now created by atomic force microscopy, but sometimes the SEM is used. It is very costly. So today in this lecture we are talking about SEM. Sorry, TEM. So as you can see into the image, the microscopes is inverted. Now the electron gun is heated and generated the electron beam. Now electron beam is straightened and come through a anode. Now accelerating voltage is give a higher and a strong power to electron beam to bombard. Now through electro lenses, the bombard into the object, and through object transmit an object, and the image is formed on the fluorescent paper, which is held in the under the below the microscope. Now this image is shown see by the computer or by camera. So this is all about the TEM microscopy. I hope you learn, and if you want to learn anything from me, you can comment below the comment section. Thank you.